Our next speaker is a trailblazer in LGBT politics in California and San Francisco, former San Francisco supervisor, former state assembly member, former state senator, the star of a wonderful documentary, Political Animals, which really teaches a lot of us about the work that had to be done to overcome homophobia and hostility in the state legislature, and the important role that four lesbians played as assembly members in changing that dynamic, and someone who was a real confidant of Wayne, someone that he loved dearly, Carol McKinney.
I met Wayne in 1979. He was my friend, and I cared about him very much. There was a time when Wayne reigned. Top of the morning on Thursday, everybody rushed to find the newspaper in his column, hoping that we had been named, but at the very least, that we had not been defamed. Wayne was the first gay talk of the town columnist. His column appeared for decades in the Bay Area Reporter. People loved to tell him to break in them. You could find out what those secrets were. Wayne tried to make us believe that he was rough and aloof, but we all know that he was warm-hearted, he was a loyal and very good friend. He wrote with concision and precision. He didn't sugarcoat things, he was frank. And as Dennis said, during the holiday season, he would write that New Year's column, naming special individuals to whom he offered good tidings. If your name was not in that column, it ruined your holiday. It blanketed the whole week of misery. If your name was in the column, but further back than the year before, people looked at you with pity. It was always fun to talk to Wayne, to have lunch with him at Harvey's, sometimes with Dennis or Jack Davis. He always had interesting intel, and he pumped you for any morsel of dish that you could cough up. It was raucous, it was full of gossip, not trashy, interesting. And he always asked about me, about Chris, and about my life. Not for publication, but for friendship. He once told me I was his second favorite female politician. The first was Dianne Feinstein, hands down. I had no quarrel with that. But Wayne, why differentiate, I asked. Where do I stand when you put in the boys? Many of whom he had referred to as she during the luncheon. This was the point where Wayne would begin to eat and bite into the burger, and nothing further was said. Wayne was smart and self-taught. He had integrity, self-confidence. He was tough, he was honest, and he was a true friend, for we held on to each other during some bumpy times. I will miss Wayne, I already do. Goodbye, my friend. All the right people are here, and we are in the Herbst Theater. Yeah, you heard me right. The Herbst Theater. I swear to God, Wayne. Yes, the place is packed. It's a full house of people here to express their love, respect, and feeling of loss, of course. And yes, I speak for everyone. Shalom, my dear friend. I won't forget you. You touched my heart deeply.